Hello and welcome back to iBluairJgR Gaming for Comedy. This is UNCUT XCOM 2 Alien Hunters featuring Shen's Last Gift. As we near the end of our campaign against Advent and the aliens, it's time for us to recruit our final soldier. Before we introduce our final soldier, the name was provided by Heban Z Refi. So, Heban, thank you for watching, thank you for commenting, thank you for submitting a really cool name. This is your soldier. Shane Long is a man who believes he always draws the short straw, but recent events have him feeling like the opposite is true. One of the few surviving members of a resistance outpost that was attacked recently, Shane and the other survivors were picked up by XCOM and brought back to Resistance HQ, where they would ultimately be retired from their resistance duties. However, unlike the other survivors, Shane has been intent on continuing the fight. He feels this sudden stroke of good luck shouldn't be wasted, though he acknowledges that he may yet draw the proverbial short straw in the future. Since returning to Resistance Headquarters and the Avenger, the other soldiers have been referring to him as Short because he tells stories of his unfortunate luck very often. So, let's see if Shane Short Long has a little bit of good luck left in him. Alright folks, it is time once again to take the fight directly to the Advent. We are assaulting one of their facilities, Operation Doomhound. Alright, we are about to blow this thing out of the water. Nothing fancy, but what is going to be fancy is the squad we're bringing with us today. So let's get right into it. Okay, let's talk about the mechanical elephants in the room. We have three Spark units coming with us to battle today. Argus the Cyclops, we already know a lot about him, but we don't know about is the way the other end of the Spark unit's skill tree or ability tree functions. So Argus is a very defensive unit. We can use him as cover, he's got additional armor, and he can heal himself. He's very defensive. Well, these Spark units, we've spec'd them in a more offensive direction, and we'll talk about that more when we actually get into the mission. So let's go over the rest of the squad. First up, we got our new guy, Shane Long, aka Short. Thank you, Heban, for submitting this character name. It's very cool. I like the backstory. He's coming in with the EMP bomb and the blue screen rounds. He is an infantry class, and he's spec'd for that just straight up rifle damage. He's going to do a lot of damage with his assault rifle. He's going to be able to do some very powerful things with it. Next up, we have Rob Cool Blue, our resident combat hacker. He's coming with a single med kit and a Skulljack. I don't know why I can't remember the names of stuff today. And then next up, we have Melissa Hayes. She is our grenade-focused grenadier. She's coming in with the plasma blaster, one acid bomb, and two plasma grenades. And last but certainly not least, our one and only psionic operative, Sadie White. She's coming in with that mind shield and the mimic beacon. What the hell is wrong with me today? I can't remember names for anything. So we're gonna see what psionic abilities we can use. I think I've upgraded some of them, so we'll see how things play out. So let's get into the action. Okay, let's do it. It is time to mobilize the mechanical men. Look at this. I would be terrified if I was Advent. All right, this is insane. So we've got a decent way to go before we get to the actual objective, but there's no time limit, so we can take it easy on that in that regard. And there we go. Our Spark units have been concealed. But the first thing you're going to notice about the difference between Argus is that Argus has one additional point of armor over the other guys, so he's going to be a little bit more durable in that regard. And I just realized I did not bring a battle scanner with me, so I'm gonna have to be a little bit more cautious about the movements that I make, especially with the Spark units. They have a very large detection radius, so I'm not gonna be able to make too many brazen moves with them right off the bat. And another thing to note that I forgot to mention, both of the alternate Spark units, I guess we'll call them, yeah, just the other Spark units that aren't Argus are using the Shredstorm guns. So they both have Shredstorm guns as their heavy weapon of choice. So, with all that said, let's get into it, man. Let's get right in there and start doing some work. Boom. Look at this. I mean, this seems crazy. The Spark unit is a lot of fun, right? It functions like a grenadier, but it's different enough. I've said this before, but it's different enough that it feels special when you use it, you know, just the abilities that it has, and the fact that you can use it as cover. You can just do unique things with it that you can't do with a standard Grenadier, and I like that about the Spark unit. Now, in this engagement is actually going to be a little bit rocky because we're very tightly packed in this area. So if I'm pretty sure there's going to be an Andromedon and a bunch of other enemies that I don't really want to deal with while I'm packed so tightly together, but hopefully we'll be able to spread out a little bit more once this turn is over. There's no rush, so what the hell? What am I worried about? I could take as long as I need for this, man. But, yeah, man, these things are heavy, and those feet are very loud, too. Okay. So it looks like this pod over here is not actually going to move at all, so we may have to engage them first, because they're gonna wind up flanking us if we don't, so it may just be in our best interest to eliminate them as quickly and as efficiently as possible. But we don't have a good shot on them. Well, I think I know what I'm going to do. I think we're just going to go for the most basic of basic Overwatches. We're going to Overwatch all others. And then Mr. Shane Long is going to start off using those blue screen rounds on this turret. For once, we're not going to blow up the floor beneath it. We're just going to take a nice shot at it. Instant kill, blue screen rounds. If you didn't know before, now you know, they're freaking powerful. And let's see what happens. Let's see what other pods are on the map. Let's kick this shit down. You know, let's get this going. Okay, we need to recalibrate that guy a little bit. He missed. But so far, so good. So far, so good. Here we go. Here's Argus. This is classic. Miss. I had a lot of faith that Argus was going to hit. Okay, everybody's missing today. This is not good. Man, okay, okay. Could be a lot worse. So we killed the Archon. Everybody wound up taking shots at that thing. So these Vipers are going to activate, and they're going to hopefully not grab any of the human soldiers that are remaining anytime soon. So let's see. We do have one more shot left with Shane Long, so what the hell, we're going to use it. This is the light him up ability. That's why he's getting to take two shots without moving. Beautiful. We eliminated one of the Vipers. All good things today. His luck has yet to run out. This is good stuff right now. Yeah, man, it feels good, man. I'm feeling that confidence coming back, you know what I'm saying? We talked a little bit about confidence. You know, when you play a game, it makes you feel confident before you go somewhere. That's what I'm feeling right now as I'm violating these aliens, whooping that ass. And that Sectopod is on the roof, just destroying property as always. And it looks like we have a gatekeeper as well. We're going to have to deal with that thing before it turns out some zombies. But, you know, the thing with the gatekeeper on missions like this, there aren't too many units that it can turn into zombies other than the advent that I kill. So if I deal with the gatekeeper before I deal with the advent, then it's not going to be able to res any zombies. This is interesting. That's all I'm going to say about that. But for anybody that did watch the previous episode... Fuck my life. We're not going to talk about this right now. We got to deal with this. We got to deal with this. Oh, please don't. All right, I spit some acid. That's not too big a deal. I was just talking about this on Reddit the other day. I left a comment about how there was one mission. This was the one mission that I cheated on very severely, where I killed all the AI and you know, I've used pretty much every one of the good cheat codes that are in the console commands to win a mission. This was the mission where I killed the Archon King, for those of you who don't exactly remember what I am referring to. Shit, he's... that. Okay, bad positioning. We gotta work this out. This is a little bit tricky. Alright, so we're going to make use of one of the new abilities that we have with this Spark unit, and it is called Strike. So what we're going to do is we're going to run up to this Viper and punch its frickin' teeth in. So let's go. Vaulting over the wall. It grazed it. It grazed it. I was hoping that would have been a death, but it's fine. We're still, you know, it worked out all right. It worked out all right. Really, what I wanted to happen, the main thing that I wanted to happen, I wanted to free Rob Cool Blue from the clutches, and that's what we did. Now, let's switch back over to our other Spark units, see what other new abilities that we have. Now, right now, there's a lot of guys clumped together over here. And I get the feeling a Shred Storm is in order. Now, I can't hit everybody. Yes, I can. I can hit everybody that I want to hit. Let's do it. Shred Storm. Violation. Look at that. It's too much. But yeah, I got into a little bit of an argument on Reddit, and by that I mean I posted, you know, just a harmless little comment about how I cheated this one time and it caused my game to bug. And then this guy gets on his high horse and he starts saying, because what I said was, I cheated in XCOM in my single player campaign because I felt like, you know, it was bullshit. You know, it was bullshit. Okay. I was frustrated. I was tired. I did the mission multiple times and I kept failing at it. I had enough. So I cheated. I put in some cheat codes. All right. But this guy, oh no. Don't cheat while this guy's on patrol, because he will get very upset with you. All right. Now, before we finish that, I got to think about the moves that I want to make here. Plasma Blast. Now, the reason this is a bit of a tricky situation is because if I can angle myself right, I'll be able to kill a lot of the enemies that are on the field right now. Because I have access to a lot of explosives, but it's just a matter of really getting in range. And I think I may be able to get in range with Sadie White. It's going to put her in a pretty precarious situation because she is now definitely in range of the Sectopod. So if that thing decides to go after her, it will be violation. But oh, this is so worth it. The reward far outweighs the risk in this situation. Fire off that beautiful ball of death. Look at that. Priceless. If you didn't know why psionic operatives were powerful before, now you freaking know. So, I cheated in that mission with the Archon King because I was fed up, I was tired of it, and, you know, everything that was happening, all the things that were conspiring against me, they were perfectly reasonable within the confines of the game, right? I have a bunch of difficulty mods installed. I have improved AI, increased enemy squad size, all pods active, and I'm playing on commander difficulty. There's a lot of things that I am consciously... If this thing does not get shut down, I hate this game. I did it. Fuck out of here. Okay, and I got an achievement for that too. Mech Lord. So there we go. We shut down the Sectopod, so it is going to not be a threat. So I know what I've done. I've made this game way harder than it's supposed to be. And I acknowledge that. But I also need to acknowledge the fact that sometimes, even though I am fully aware of the things I'm doing, that sometimes just it's bullshit. It's straight up bullshit. You know? Just sometimes things are bullshit. That's my point. And when I believe that things are bullshit, I will cheat. Okay? It's a really dumb story, and for whatever reason, for reasons I will never fully understand, I got really pissed off at the fact that this guy was telling me that I'm wrong for cheating in XCOM. And I'm just gonna let you know, anybody that plays XCOM on PC, uses a lot of console commands, if you cheat, you ain't wrong. I'm right there with you, brother. If you cheat, if you got them cheat codes hooked up, if you doing your thing, you know, you get frustrated, you want to use them console commands, that's on you, man, and I respect it. A gatekeeper violating, summoning a bunch of zombies, and damaging its own unit in the process. Oh, wait, no. Oh, yes. Yes. No? Yes? I don't know. I don't know what happened there. Oh. Okay. Well, it's time for some Walking Dead action, am I right? Shit. But yeah, my point is, if you want to cheat in XCOM, there's nothing wrong with that. If you've ever felt bad about cheating, don't, because it's fine. It's not that serious. It's a game. And you know, people, we play games to have fun. And if sometimes you feel like the game is conspiring against you, and if you feel like putting in a couple of cheat codes will make you feel better, then you know what? Fucking do it. So let's get back into the action. We're going to use the bombard ability on this group of guys because we're not in a position to really destroy the gatekeeper. We're not going to be able to destroy the gatekeeper, so for once we may actually take some zombie damage. So bombard is a cool ability where you throw out the little bit thing that you carry around that uses the heavy weapons, and you just toss it like a football, and it goes over there and it deals some damage. So that was very powerful. So we got a little bit more damage on this the sectopod, took out its shield, and also we destroyed some, we got a little bit of collateral damage and took out one of those advent troopers. We still have a field of zombies in our path, so that's kind of a big deal. But we can manage. It's still manageable. Now here, no, we lost vision on the gatekeeper. How did that happen? Well, it's time to find him again. Let's try and get up in that action. But so far though, this is actually going way better than I thought it was gonna go. Because the tricky part about using the spark units is that they can't take cover, so it does pose a little bit of a problem in that regard. Because, you know, if you put them in a position where they'll take a lot of fire, then it's very easy to put the spark in a position where it is going to take a tremendous amount of damage. And if I didn't get lucky and have a lot of enemies clumped up together, then my spark units would have just taken fire from every single one of these advent troopers that are now zombified. So, you know, it's an interesting situation that we got going on here. And I actually don't really know how to deal with it. I don't really know. So I guess, I don't think we're going to be able to take out those zombies. So let's just try and get people moved up. Sadie White is in a very bad spot, so we're actually going to pull her back so she doesn't get wombo comboed. So yeah, we're just going to keep Sadie White safe for now. I probably could throw the Mimic Beacon out with her, and I think that's what I'm going to do. So on the off chance that the gatekeeper comes and Kool-Aid mans through this door, he will go after the Mimic Beacon. And then the rest of the guys, we're just gonna... Let's move Argus up and then put him on Overwatch. What the hell? Oh, we can see things now. Uh-oh. Shit. Maybe we shouldn't have moved Argus up. I'm actually regretting my decision a little bit. Yeah, what the hell? Since we moved him up, let's get that plasma blast. Wait. No. I don't want to destroy the wall. Okay, I think I have an idea. I'm going to use the sacrifice ability on all of these zombies. And then they're all going to go after Argus? I think that's how it works. Because I still haven't figured out exactly how the sacrifice ability works. But we're going to find out. We're experimenting. If you're watching and you know how the sacrifice ability works, please tell me in the comments. Because I swear I do not freaking know. I just can't. I couldn't begin to tell you how it works. We'll just Overwatch with this guy. All right, let's see what happens. Oh, crap. Okay, so even though the Mimic Beacon is there, I'm not sure if because the gatekeeper doesn't see it, he's not actually going to go for it. So this is interesting. But all right, Argus is taking fire, and he's building up that channeled energy, and the intimidates are going to start coming out. Be afraid of the man, Argus the Cyclops. That's what I'm talking about, shooting that zombie in the back. Yeah, like, you know, games are meant to be an escape. You know, they're meant to... This guy just phased through that wall. All that to attack a hologram. Totally worth it. For me. You know, but yeah, games are meant to be an escape, you know, and sometimes... When it feels like that game is no longer an escape and it feels like it's getting frustrating, then, you know, what are you left to do besides plug in a couple cheat codes to see what happens, to make it feel a little bit better? You know, if you had a bad day, you're taking one down. I don't know the lyrics to that song, but we're going to turn it around. You just got to cheat sometimes. I'm a firm believer that cheating is good for the soul, and just in video games. Like, if you're in a relationship, don't cheat on the person you're in a relationship with. And the sacrifice ability, if nothing else, it's given Argus a tremendous amount of armor so that all of the damage that he's potentially taking is just getting mitigated. I mean, he is a beast right now. 7 points of armor, only going to take one damage. Look at that. These are some strong-ass zombies, too. And somebody should tell Argus that you can't make a zombie panic. But and this zombie is apparently a little bit slow, because he just kind of walked around and did nothing. But I'm not complaining about that by any means. So so here we go. Let's deal with this. Now, another one of the new abilities on our other Spark units is, I don't even know what it's called. Adaptive Aim, that's right. When I activate the Overdrive ability, now normally when I do that with Argus, every time I take a shot, my chance to hit gets reduced. But with these guys, because they have the Adaptive Aim ability, their chance to hit does not get reduced. And even with that... I have a really... The Gatekeeper is a ridiculous enemy, so we're going to kill it by doing something ridiculous. Another new ability that we have with our other Spark units is called Nova. So we're going to use the Nova ability, and you're going to see how powerful it is right now. It has... You can essentially use it as long as you have health. So it's a free action. Activate it, and it deals damage. Boom. And it ignores armor. Now, every subsequent activation of the Nova ability, boom, I damage myself with it. But I've got a lot of health, so I feel confident that... Okay, now I'm pretty sure it doubles every time I use it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to repair before I activate it one more time. Oh, this is a lot of fun right now. The coolest thing about endgame XCOM is that you get to just take the piss on these enemies. I mean, the strategy that I'm doing right now is... It's silly. It's completely silly. Like, I'm legit shitting all over these enemies right now. And now that thing is actually about to blow up, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to move out of its range with this guy, because I may as well just only take damage with one of the Spark units. Why get them both bruised up? And we're going to finish it off with one more Nova. Fuck it, because it's guaranteed damage. I just want it to happen. And, you know, I just think it's cool. I just think it's cool. There's definitely a more practical way to do that. I could have used Rob Cool Blue and Combat Protocol, but that was just cool, okay? That was just... I enjoyed that. I do these things for me. And another thing that I'm going to do for me, I'm going to treat myself right now by punching this guy in the face. So, say hello to the left hook. Oof. That actually looks really painful. Honestly. I mean, geez, man, that... I would not want to get hit with that, that's all I'm saying. I'd rather get electrocuted to death than have my face, like, literally exploded by a giant mechanical man. Alright, but all things considered, though, this mission went extremely well. We've got great shot percentages on the remaining enemies. Shane is going to finish this guy off. Boom, right in the chest. For a guy that we... The story that came up for him is that he feels like he's got bad luck, but he's consistently had good shot percentages for the entirety of this mission. So, you know, his luck is turning around. In a very big way. It looks like we got one guy left, so let's run in this building and take care of him. But at this point, the mission is pretty much over. They may call some reinforcements, but it's seriously nothing we can't handle. So I'm going to close it out here. Violation. I'm going to close it out here by saying the name of the game is XCOM 2. The name of the channel is iBluairJgR Game for Comedy. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Let's blow this facility out the water.